Hit him with a welcome, welcome, welcome all, because I got to do the Corey Graves impression. But this is, I know this, I say this often, really often on the channel, but this is a little something different. We don't normally do this when it comes to the pay-per-views of Warzone, but this time around, we got ourselves a kickoff show for the road to glory. And there's a nice little detail for today. I'm not by myself. I'm also joined, you know her, through the persona of Sierra J, and you probably also recognize her from the voice that runs with me in Dragon Ball The Breakers. But now we have Sierra J who's joining me, and we're gonna run ourselves through this card. Sierra, are you here?
See, I am here indeed.
All right, so you're here, I'm here, the people are here. Why don't we break down a couple of these matches that we got going on, starting things out with the Men's Royal Rumble. It will be one man that's going to outlast 29 other men, and he's going to punch his ticket to Revelations. It's going to be a hectic something, but at the same time, it's going to be a memorable something. We're not going to get fully in-depth into all these matches right now, because we're going to go back and talk about them. But one of them that's going to be talked about even after tonight is the Universal Heavyweight Championship match taking place between King and Steve, the past versus the present. One man leaves here as the undisputed Universal Heavyweight Champion. Will that be the Hall of Famer Steve, or will the gold-blooded King continue his reign? And we're still not done, because the Women's Championship is also being defended. My guest is going to be defending the championship against Tia Tyson. It's going to be, how do you say, difficult for Tia Tyson in this matchup. That's the belief. But again, we're going to dive into it a little bit later, because that's not all that we have to discuss. One match in particular that I'm waiting to see is the Intercontinental Championship matchup between the Joke and the Enchant. It's gotten very, very personal, and I have this slight feeling that the Joke is gonna fall here tonight to Ian Chen. And that right there, that ain't even all. You know why? Because we still have more action. We got more things to cover. The Women's Intercontinental Championship is also on the line. Alexia, hoping to get some type of redemption for her and her partner. She goes one-on-one with Angel Flores, and boy, that's going to be a clash. But we said something about clashes. We said something about people being good, and we said something about memorable moments. And that takes us into our very next match, which is the Tag Team Championship matchup that takes place between the Dream Chasers and then Evan Ryan. I don't know if Evan and Ryan can get this one done tonight, because the Dream Chasers are looking to make history and make their name mean something here in Warzone, instead of it just being, you know, them hood guys. And then we gotta do something special here, because Danny has suffered. I know when we get into it, she's gonna have a lot to say on Danny versus Jay Pierce, but Danny has been suffering, and hopefully tonight his suffering ends and he can actually call himself the United States champion. But jumping into the matches, we're going to start with the Women's Royal Rumble. Sierra J, I'm sending this to you. Who is it that you believe is coming out of the Royal Rumble on top? Oh, wait, hold on. I did that to you. We'll do it one more time. You know, I wasn't able to hear what you were saying.
Did what? I said Jenna Jordan. It has to be her. It has to be her. She has to win this.
You say that Jenna Jordan has to win the Women's Royal Rumble. Why is it that you say that?
Well, what a lot of people don't know behind the scenes is that Jenna Jordan has been, she's been my girl, even though she's been out. But, you know, since the beginning of this show, it's been her. Okay, it's been her for me.
I think truthfully you got attached to Jenna Jordan when she was signed.
I did
I don't know. Girl. I don't think I shared it as much as you did when it came to Jenna, like being
she did so good in the beginning, though.
Yeah, she did.
She did amazing.
I agree with that.
If there's anybody who deserves it, it's her. It's her.
Yeah, Jenna has done like solid work since her arrival. But at the same time, you got to think about some different names that are going to be there. It's going to be, of course, Jenna Jordan in this matchup. But at the same time, you got people who go by the name of Trinity that's there. You got people that go by the name of Marilyn Lopez that are going to be there. It's a couple of different names.
She would probably be my second choice.
Who?
Marilyn. I think she would be my second choice.
Marilyn Lopez. That's your second choice.
I mean, she's worked hard when she, you know, tried to fight me and everything, or at least my character. And she put up a good fight, so if she does win, you know, it's like, I tip my hat to her. She worked for it, okay?
I get that. Yeah, it's one of those moments where it's like, you don't really want to discredit everything that she's done, because Marilyn Lopez is a household name, and it's kind of the moment of, somebody's gotta be the standout here. And I think Marilyn Lopez might be in the running for that. But how do you get past somebody that kinda goes by the name of Andrea Dune, the big massive woman that kinda showed up in her debut and destroyed Kylie Rose?
I thought she'd be here. My memory's like a little horrible. I thought Marilyn beat her.
No, Marilyn hasn't competed against Andrea Doom, but I'm saying in the Rumble, she's gonna have to. If she wants to win, she may have to deal with Andrea Doom, and I feel like that might be catastrophic for her.
She dealt with the Amazon woman. I think she can do this. I believe in her.
As an interesting perspective, because personally, if I had to give my winner on, you know, tonight's match with the Rumble and all of that, if I had to give my winner, I'm truthfully going to throw everything I feel to Trinity, just because it's one of those things. I don't think I'm biased when it comes to Trinity. I just think, truthfully, Trinity is the next thing. Of course.
You think Trinity can hold the women's title?
I don't know if Trinity is the woman to hold the women's title. I don't think so.
My point is that. Jenna, she can hold the women's title.
Matter of fact, you know what? I'm overlooking somebody, and I know I made that mistake. So, the person that I've overlooked, that is going to be my official pick for this entire thing. And with a good 30 seconds left on our clock, my official prediction tonight is Sandra Flores. I go with Sandra Flores because why not?
Not again.
The first woman to go back-to-back Royal Rumbles and win, that's going to be Sandra Flores. I can say that right now. With the last 13 seconds on the clock, your official prediction is who?
Jenna Jordan.
Jenna Jordan is your official prediction, and this has just been only one of the discussions for tonight. We will be right back again with more of the discussion with tonight's kickoff show.
The United States Championship. Some may call it a workhorse championship. Others may call it the Elite Championship. But sometimes after a while, the Elite finds its even match. Jay Pierce looks to shake the foundation of Warzone and destroy its handpicked champion. and Donnie is determined to retain and put an end to the fairy tale story. And after getting the best of the Elite on three different occasions, Jay Pierce is looking to make his mark on Warzone's roster and win his first championship, the coveted United States Championship.
For that to be one of the matches taking place tonight, we gotta do a little bit of discussion when it comes to this matchup here, because our next matchup to break down is Donnie versus Jay Pierce for the United States Championship. Again, I'm gonna throw this to you because this is one that's very, very personal for you, Sierra. Donnie versus Jay Pierce. What is your take?
Donnie's gonna win. Donnie's gonna be fresh off.
You say I'm biased, but I believe that's a biased decision when it comes to talking about this match.
No. It's not a biased decision, okay? It's a fact, okay? Come, you got it. It's Donnie. Okay, Donnie has been killing the game, okay? He has been at the top and should always be at the top. Come on now.
You do know there are people who would disagree with that statement, and they would say that Donnie does not deserve to be anywhere near any kind of championship.
And I can say the same about a lot of people who shouldn't be up there with the championship, but I'm not, because I'm not a biased person.
So it's that feel that it'll be Donnie's handed this and Donnie's handed that, and then he's just given this opportunity and given that opportunity. And I feel like that entire concept may rub people the wrong way. I don't know.
Everybody's given an opportunity here. We don't just hand out opportunities. We do what we do best. We let people fight for these opportunities, okay? And Donnie has done that. Everybody here who's in Road to Glory has fought their way to be here, okay? So what bias, what favoritism is really happening here?
When you think about it, they're going to point out these specific moments, and these specific moments kind of include what has happened to Donnie over the past 3 weeks. Donnie's been, he's gotten bested. I can't even say 3 weeks no more. It's 4 weeks now that he's been put in his place by every single person he stepped forward to, including Jay Pierce three times.
But everybody has bad days though. So not everybody is perfect. Let's talk about the times beforehand, okay? How did he get the championship, man? How did he get it?
He beat Azrael clean.
So, a top contender. He beat clean. He beat Travis Amir clean.
This is true. Was one of those people that he beat. This is true.
A champion. A former world champion. Two of them, actually. I'm sorry, because Azrael was a champion. A two belt champion of that, and Donnie won.
You're not wrong, because Donnie does. He possesses all the skill and everything needed to actually go far and be great, which he's done. Donnie has done that. I can't take away anything from him. He for sure is that guy. But every guy meets his match, and you don't believe Jay Pierce is his match?
If Azrael wasn't his match, I doubt that this man is going to be his match, okay?
I get it with the confidence for him. I personally am worried for Donnie in this match just simply because Donnie has been beat on like I've never seen him beat on before. And it's been rather sad to really see, like, oh yeah, he ain't got no chance. Even when he did the attacking, like, he attacked Jay Pierce from behind and still lost that encounter. I don't know. I don't really know where it goes, but again, we've reached this moment. 30 seconds on the clock. The official pick for Donnie versus Jay Pierce. My pick for this is that we're going to have a new United States champion.
Still Donnie for me. Donnie got this. I believe in him.
You're still rolling with Donnie. Her pick is still Donnie. My pick is Jay Pierce. We're going to find out when this show goes live who it's going to be. But there's another match that's got a different kind of feel to it. It's got a different feel to it for a different reason. And again, putting our five on the clock, the tag team championships are on the line. The Dream Chasers are going against the defending champions, Evan and Ryan. And Evan and Ryan kind of, they've been missing on the scene for a while. And I don't know if that hurts their momentum or not.
So here, I'm a little biased, and this is where I'm going to be a little biased. Well, nope, it's not even being biased. Yeah, it is. It is. Personally, I don't believe either of these teams deserve the spot that they're in. For one, I don't see Evan and Ryan as champions. So they are yawn to me. Even the Ohana boys have more entertainment than what they can provide for me. The Dream Chasers? Okay, nothing to say. I really don't care because I don't know who they are. Who are they? Who are the Dream Chasers? Desperees, it to me, is what they seem like. If you ask me, there is somebody who's better fit for this spot than anybody. But that's for another time.
You feel like there is another tag team that belongs in this position?
Yes, absolutely.
I mean, we're here to talk about the tag team championships. Who do you feel should be in either one of these spots right now?
I mean, if I'm being honest, I would say the Golden Era, or I'm sorry, what's that tag team's name? Because we haven't heard them so long, because now I associate them as the Golden Era.
No, you're talking about just the two of them.
Yes.
The two of them were called the Young Gold, but all three are the Golden Era.
The Golden Era, yep. Because they've been such a good, amazing group. That's all I can associate them as. It's just the Golden Era. That's who I believe deserved this spot, okay? Because when they were tag team champions, they were the top of the game. They brought it every single time, okay? Here in Warzone, okay, what we see behind scenes and we watch everything play out, our champions still stay champions, okay? And they are become great champions. They become entertaining champions. Who is Evan and Ryan? Who are they? How did they get here?
For the people who are going to, I know it's going to be, that's why I'm saying this, but for the people who are going to defend the tag team of Evan and Ryan, I do recognize what Evan and Ryan bring to the table, the same that I recognize what the Dream Chasers bring. But at the same time, this tag team division is filled at this point with so many different varieties. And I kind of feel what it is that she's saying, where it's like, this feels like it would kind of have fallen flat, but I feel like the Dream Chasers, as of late, have been trying to kind of throw their names into this position. And the way that they have come about to this spot right now, it is making all the difference to me. And I think the Dream Chasers tonight are going to be the ones that get the job done. And then we're going to get to see them in these matches with these teams that we want to see them in. We want to see them face teams like the Scrap Soldiers. We want to see them face teams like the Golden Era. We want to see them face a bunch of different teams. But we got to make it through tonight, and we got to see who's it going to be that carries the tag team torch and they take it all the way to Revelations. So, with that being said, tonight, we don't have the Golden Era. We don't have the Combat Project. We don't have the Scrap Soldiers. We got the Dream Chasers and Evan and Ryan. Sierra J, who leaves tonight as Tag Team Champions.
I'm going to put my faith and hope into Evan and Ryan.
Putting faith into Evan and Ryan, that'll be completely opposite from what it is that I say is going to be happening here tonight, because I believe the Dream Chasers leave as the new Tag Team Champions. That, with that being said, we're able to move on to our first bit of action that's going to take place here tonight. Trinity goes one-on-one with Marilyn Lopez to settle a very, very difficult and bitter score. It's one of those moments for any person who has not stayed up to date with everything happening in Warzone. And if you haven't, that is truthfully a mistake, because this has been some of the craziest times to be a member of the Warzone universe. I know I've been able to call these different things that's happened, but I can ask you, just as a person who has been kind of watching it and hasn't been in the calling these matches, when you see Marilyn Lopez versus Trinity after the attacks that have been done by Trinity and everything of that nature, how do you think Marilyn fares here tonight?
Oh, but I have faith in her. Honestly, I do. I feel like after she had fought my character, me, after that time, and after all the beef that we went through and everything like that, I think she's gonna make it. I think she's going to deliver today. That's my choice. I really do think she's gonna win this.
Her believing in Marilyn Lopez is completely different from what it is that I can say. Why? Because my faith is wholeheartedly in the Fallen Goddess. It is wholeheartedly in the Rebel Diva, and it is wholeheartedly in Trinity. I don't think any person should be able to bet against Trinity in this kind of situation. I don't think any person should be able to bet against Trinity at all. But, you know, that's not for me to determine. That is for Trinity to show.
I'm still gonna get to that. Probably because I don't fully know who Trinity is.
And see, that's the thing too. That plays such a huge factor in these different situations when people don't exactly know who it is that's being dealt with. So like a miniature rundown of who this is that Trinity actually is. She got the name the Rebel Diva from, of course, being different than the others, being that standout woman on the roster. She wore all the dark colors and she did all the extraordinary things, but at the end of the day, all she wanted to do was kick your head off. And I know right now that's all she wants to do to Marilyn. For some odd reason, we still don't know the reason as to why it is she wants to do it, but she wants to kick her head off.
That, or she could just be very reckless.
That's true too. You know, there's sometimes not an exact answer for the reason that something is happening. But I think just with Marilyn being able to have this chance to get her hands on Trinity, I think she's going to be doing just fine. And she's starting it out. Uh-oh. I was about to hype her, but I didn't get a chance to really, like, hype her up because... hello? So, like, what did you... Oh, well, good night. It's been real. Appreciate you. Oh, okay. So, you know, I was going to talk extra heavy if that was the end just that fast. You realize that?
Mm-hmm. I know you would have.
I mean, just even right now, she's still, like, she's giving her the hands, and it's the unfortunate thing, like, I don't know.
But you never know, though. A person could be, Marilyn right now could just be like, let me get a feel to her fight style. Let me see what kind of person she is. And then from there, she'd probably be get the upper hand. You never know.
I do know that she just had a knee on the back of her head, and she's not exactly playing nice right now. She's trying to kick her head off her shoulders like she just kicked her in the chest, and this is potentially probably where it ends, because this is Trinity, right? She's going to pick you up, she's going to hold you there, and she's going to drop you on your head. That's it. Ball game. Do us a favor. Really? One and done. I don't know what it is you expected to happen in this match, but I do know I called this to happen. Of course, our winner is Trinity. Marilyn Lopez can go back to doing whatever she's doing and hope to potentially win the Women's Royal Rumble later on tonight. But I knew where this was going. I knew how this was about to happen. There is still so much more to come in the pre-show, but for the moment, Trinity takes the win. We're gonna take ourselves a small little break, and we'll be right back to break down some more of the action that's still to come. Six days separate us from Revelations, but tonight this is Road to Glory, and this is also right now the kickoff show to Road to Glory. And since you know it's the kickoff show, you know we got some more matches to break down, and there's one match in particular that we have to break down, and it's been a little bit of a whirlwind, I guess you can call it. We've had almost a struggle of sorts for the Women's Intercontinental Champion to put down Alexia. I don't really know how to better describe it, because Alexia didn't have a partner to start out with, but then was eventually joined by her partner Victoria, and then they both got beat on by the Flores Twins. So Sierra J, I'm sending this one to you, because you got some experience dealing with the Flores Twins. What do you think is the outcome for Alexia and Victoria here tonight?
Today I'm gonna have to give it up to the Flores Twins. This is their ballpark. Okay, like, if there's anybody who may seem like a little bit of a threat to Sierra J, it would probably be the Flores Twins. It will possibly be the Flores Twins. Now, I'm not scared to go, or at least my character's not scared to go into this battle with them, but if there's anybody who poses a tiny bit of a challenge, it will be them.
Posing a challenge to Sierra J. That is a very, very important detail in this entire encounter tonight. I believe it poses a really, really big deal, simply because Angel and Sandra, when they're on the same page, I don't think you'll find a better unit on the women's roster, like, at all. And for Alexia and Victoria, this probably is going to be one of those moments where we gotta see genuine teamwork or some help from the outside, or some miracle has to happen for us to have a new Women's Intercontinental Champion tonight.
Yeah, Something.
You just said something has to happen, because if you look down the history of what Angel and Sandra accomplished together, initially Sandra was here on her own and then was later joined by her sister. And ever since the two of them got together, it was the moment in time where Sandra reigned over the women's division as the women's champion. And Angel was there as the supporting character, but now Angel isn't the supporting character. Now Angel is the one that's defending the championship and simply having the experience, and not even just the experience, but having someone out there of your own flesh and blood, that adds a different level of competition in the performer. So, do you believe that Alexia has any chance tonight? I can say personally, I don't. But do you believe she has any chance tonight?
No, I do not.
I don't even... I don't want it to just sound like we don't care, but it's one of those things.
Look,
like,
if you don't know who the Flores twins are, then you about to learn who they are, okay? Like, there's nothing you can work around that, okay? It's the Flores twins, okay? Them two by themselves together can cause mayhem, all right?
That's really true. That's really true. That's a nice way to put it. Just simply put, they can cause some mayhem. Like, they can actually cause mayhem by themselves. They had a feud over the women's championship, and they caused mayhem still with fighting each other. So if they're trying to keep the women's intercontinental championship, then they're going to for sure do everything in their power to do so. And I don't think they fail.
Let's really talk about it, because here's a nice little tip for you. Why would I or my character decide to choose them as the tag team to go against, who was it, Tiffany and Amber, and I can't remember who the last girl was.
The last one was Melissa. I ain't forgot. That was for sure. That was a statement right there of anybody that was want to step to the top of the mountain. Those are the three women that they would have to go through. But of course, as it sounds right now, we are in unison on the decision, and both of us believe Angel Flores wins tonight. There is still more to come in this pre-show, and at the current moment, we're going to take ourselves again another break to give you guys a rundown of our next matchup that is going to be taking place via The Joke versus Ian Chen.
The Joke. An entity unlike any other on the Warzone roster, who has only known one way to express himself, through pure, uncontrollable chaos. But in his path, one of the most legendary names in all of professional wrestling, fighting not only for his own honor. The House of Chen meets The Joke for the Intercontinental Championship. Will The Joke add another victim to his list, or will Ian Chen bring honor back to his family name?
It's again, we're going to welcome you back to the kickoff show, because that's one of those matches we gotta truthfully break down one of those matches, because that right there, Ian Chen versus The Joke. Let's bring this up right now, all right? Ian Chen versus The Joke for the Intercontinental Championship. That is a matchup that is going to be more than personal. Why? Over the past number of weeks, it was literally starting all with Ian Chen beating the joke. He beat the joke, and then it was one of those moments you didn't know how to predict it. You didn't know what was going to happen next. And then the joke took an even darker turn. He attacked a fan who was there to see Ian Chen. Not only doing that, he was given a match with said fan. And he proceeded to beat the absolute life out of him. So, if you're Ian Chen and you're seeing this happen, like, you don't know what direction to do, what direction to go, I should say. And you don't know what actions to do, so you just act out of emotion. That's where this kind of goes. And I'm going to throw it to my co-hosts. I'm going to throw it to Sierra J. Sierra, who do you believe leaves here out of this vengeful rivalry as the Intercontinental Champion?
You know, this one toss up in the air, because I honestly don't know. Because, like, if you really think about it, and I mean, if you're really about to break it down, let's go ahead and break it down. Ian Chen and both the Joke haven't had really a nice good run throughout this entire season of Warzone. They have not had a good run at all. But now they have came back. Grin Joke is somewhat on his own. Ian Chen has came back all fresh and new. He's no longer the demon Ian Chen. And it's just like, I don't know. I don't know what to expect anymore. Are you guys going to give me the match of the century? Are you really going to intrigue me? Or is it just going to be the same old, same old? So that's why I'm going to toss it up in the air. I will have to just see what you give me.
And I think that's really like a true way to look at the match, because this right now, this is the best that we're seeing out of both performers, like, this entire year of Warzone. Like, they have not been at the absolute top of their game, and we know that. We know that to be true already, that this is not the full potential that we can see from the Joke and Ian Chen. Both of us know that.
That's why I kind of want to just leave it in the air, because I'm like, I really don't know. I real life don't know. This one is like a, I'm going to be watching, because I really got to see. Which one of y'all going to give me the good stuff?
I think another thing to, that's important, I can say, to point out, is just simply that the Joke has had two title defenses, and in both of these title defenses he's been overly dominant in those. And I feel like Ian Chen, he kind of needs to understand that this match is not a no disqualification match, meaning he's got to keep every emotion in check, he's got to keep every action in check, and he's got to truthfully know what it is that his next move is going to be before he makes it. Because the Joke can leave here as the Intercontinental Champion on a technicality, and I know that would even further upset Ian. And I don't think we need to see that more than we've already seen it. So, with our last bit of time ticking away, Sierra J, I'm throwing it to you. You got to make one decision on who you believe is leaving as the Intercontinental Champion. Is that Ian Chen, or is it the Joke?
I'm going to say by default, because he's a champion, I'm going to say the Joke. But I really don't know. Like, that's my actual answer. I don't know, but if I had to choose, I would choose the champion, the Joke.
A Joke retention is her decision. When it comes to me, I believe I'm a little bit on a different side. I hope that this decision is right to make, because Ian Chen needs this. This is one of those moments Ian Chen needs this. He needs this moment, he needs this match, and he needs this championship to validate everything. But on talking about championships validating a superstar, when you talk about championships validating a single superstar, you have to think about the Women's champion Sierra Che. She's had literally the longest run of the modern era in the women's division. It was previously 7 months long. This is now month number 9. As the women's champion, she's beaten some of the very best. She's been tested by some of the very best. And still to this moment today, she's able to call herself the WPW women's champion. I'm throwing it to the Sierra J.
Of WPW. Get it right.
The queen of WPW. You know there's another woman that had that name? And I don't believe... Well, no, I can't even say that because she beat Marilyn Lopez within like 5 minutes. I don't know. I don't think Tia Tyson is one of those that you can just look past at all, because Tia got strength that is out of this world. But this is also Sierra J that she's dealing with. I don't think you're able to look past that either. Mm-mm. So the question, it comes to you. What is your take on this matchup?
You know, actually, you know, I think I'm gonna take this little stick or boomerang, and I'm gonna toss it back to you, because me, I'm too biased for this. Because you already know who I'm going to say. I'm going to say me. I got this. Like, it's me. I have to know. So, what is your thought on this?
My thought on this entire matchup itself, this is designed for Sierra J. The situation, the stage, the overall presentation, everything, it's all set for Sierra J. But in these moments where we never know what to happen, it could be a shocker. But at Road to Glory tonight, Tia Tyson is about to have the biggest test of her career in Warzone. This is going to be the biggest test. She's on one of the biggest stages against one of the very, very best in the entire business. And truth be told, I don't believe that this is Tia Tyson's crowning moment. I believe that Sierra J continues in her reign, and that's not a biased decision or anything, but I feel like truthfully Sierra J continues her reign tonight. I don't think it ends. I don't think Tia Tyson is the woman to do it, and I don't think this is the stage where it ends.
I don't think so either. I know for a fact it can't be. I'm too way on top of my game to be going back to the bottoms. Not me. I'll rise too quickly.
So he says, not you to fall, not here, not tonight.
Mm-mm, exactly.
Well, see, there is a really, really nice thing, because Sierra J has her eyes set on Tia Tyson here tonight, and she's also got her eyes set on 29 other women too, because the winner of the Women's Royal Rumble is going to go on to face Sierra J, most likely, because we still got Annihilation to make it through. But whoever wins that match is 9 times out of 10 gonna go on to face Sierra J at Revelations. If Tia Tyson doesn't get the job done here tonight, who is it that you're looking forward to seeing at Revelations?
To face me at Revelations?
Yep.
So, like, how are we talking here? Are we talking what would give the best match? Who would give the best match? Or
who do you think has the best chance against Sierra J?
Let's see. With the season that we have had now, my favorite will forever be Jenna Jordan, but the person who's been really putting in the work is two people, actually, who's been putting in the work, and that would be Jane Wolfe and Marilyn Lopez. those are the two who I think put in the most work that I don't think they would pose a challenge to me, but I don't think it'll be a quick fight either. That's how I would say it.
Well, speaking of quick fights, we've had a nice little something that's been running in the background, and it is probably about time to bring it forward for the rest of the world to see. And that would be the conclusion of the 2K tournament. What is the 2K tournament, you may ask? The 2K tournament is a tournament that I've held for the last 2 years, with the winners of those tournaments earning a contract here in Warzone. And for this pre-show, in our second and last matchup, we've got two men that have made it to the finals of the 2K tournament. One being Marty Martini. Now, don't let his appearance, don't let that, you know, base your judgment on. He's good. Trust me, he's good. He wouldn't have made it this far if he wasn't. But unfortunately, his opponent tonight has, how do you say, a very, very, very rich lineage in the world of wrestling. So don't take anything away from Marty Martini, but you need your eyes on his opponent. Because both men have the opportunity to make it to the Warzone roster. But my personal pick is about to be heading out here after this man here. Sierra, your take on Marty Martini.
Good luck.
Just a good luck. It's good, because that is truthfully what he needs when he's in the face of CJ Guerrero. Now you understand and you hear what that name is. That's one of the most legendary names in all of wrestling. That Guerrero last name. And this man here was born to change the game. So we got CJ Guerrero and we got Marty Martini in the finals of the 2K tournament. You see, he's accompanied by Lisa. You know, she's just out there because she get paid to walk down to the ring. That's just how these things work normally, I think.
I'm telling you, it's a nice check, though.
Such a nice check just to walk with somebody down to the ring, you know. I think it makes it better when you're walking down to the ring with your husband, though. Like, I think you're getting a check just to walk aside your husband. It's like, oh, okay. We on that type of time now. I don't know. I don't think Marty Martini can. I can't even say I don't know. It's a guarantee. Marty Martini doesn't win this tournament. He doesn't finish. He doesn't beat this man, CJ, and it's unfortunate. He's going to just fade to black while CJ Guerrero is going to go on to do some amazing things, and he going to continue to piece this man up, because why not? Just go ahead, put it on display, get it over with. That's the match. It's over. Oh, okay.
Just like that?
All right. I might have been slightly wrong. Just slightly wrong.
You're just trying to rush the match.
Come on. Oh. You're not going to pan him off that? Oh, okay. All right. I believe that he was going to do it.
Let the man do his job.
I mean, he's doing his job, you know. He's doing his job. Like, Marty did make it this far, but I think his journey stops here. Because look at that. He's made it look effortless. Don't nobody just do that, like, just day one. This man has been working, and he's been working to be able to do stuff like that. Plus, he got motivation on the outside, too. I don't think he want to lose in front of his wife. I don't think he wants to.
Yes, boy. Nobody likes that.
Especially if it's like you can prevent it. You don't have no outside interference or no. Hello? Okay. I gotta take my pause because, you know, Homie's hitting him with the three amigos, and this is going to be one of those moments to remember. CJ Guerrero using the three amigos, and now the cover. One, and done. Oh.
He said no. He said hold my beer.
Go ahead, put a fork in it. He ain't want to get done with that. So one more. Oh my God. This man just pedigreed you.
How you feel about that?
Marty. Why couldn't you just die like every other person? You could have just died. It would have all been over and we could have moved on with life. But no, you got to be difficult, right? You got to be extra difficult. Go ahead. Put him away. There we go with the frog splash. A beautiful one to end every hope for Marty Martini. That's the last time you're going to hear his name. That's the last time. The name you will remember is CJ Guerrero, because now I can proudly say he's won the 2K tournament, and now he also has earned his contract for Warzone. Interested to see what exactly is he going to do. But I know for the moment being, this is going to be a very, very interesting superstar to watch. Truth be told, he's an interesting superstar to watch, but his interesting nature does not hold a candle to what's coming up next.
Hall of Famer. The Icon. World Champion. A legend in every meaning of the word. Has come back for one last match. But to make history, he must become a Kingslayer. 567 days. King has reigned over the Warzone as Universal Champion. With a legendary reign on the line, can he do it again in the face of the Icon Steve? Who will leave as the undisputed Universal Heavyweight Champion?
We back into the actual booth, you feel me? And we gotta digest this one. We gotta break this one down and we gotta get some groundwork moving, because King versus Steve. Let's throw this up here now. Let's get this up in the air, because the undisputed Universal Heavyweight Championship is on the line. And with that being on the line, you gotta question something. You gotta question, can Steve actually keep going? How long is it gonna take King to put away the old man? And how long are they going to allow the fairy tale story to be played? So, of course, to start things off with this discussion, I'm going to throw it to you. Sierra, does Steve have any chance here tonight competing against King?
What I would like to believe is, yes, he's about to do something big, bold, and something that is never seen before, the way that he's been talking. But we all know the honest truth is he has no chance.
The honest truth is, of course, there is the respect factor. There's always going to be respect between King and Steve forever. That is a thing that's given. They were a part of probably the biggest team to ever exist in Warzone, that being the Purge. They were a part of that together for a long while. And now it is all about the undisputed Universal Heavyweight Championship. It's about the thing that King has held closest to him.
Well, that and plus no one has been able to take it off King, but besides the point.
It's like, without even mentioning the legendary reign that King has had, it almost comes off like this is the last journey for Steve. This ain't the last journey for King, and we know this ain't the last journey for King, so it's kind of obvious where this goes. Steve doesn't have, he doesn't have the momentum, he doesn't have the skill set, he doesn't have anything to dethrone someone who's been doing this for 365 days consecutively. So I think now I can probably pose the question, really, of just how is it that you believe the conditioning has to be for Steve? Like, we know he hasn't been in the ring. He had the one match with Christian, which he lost, of course, because Christian tried to tear his leg off, but that's besides the point. What do you think the conditioning for Steve has to be for anybody to dethrone King? What do you think it takes at this point?
Hope and prayers.
A lot of those. Yes. Yes, a lot of those. Hopes and prayers is one thing that just might get you somewhere when you're competing against King. Because truth be told,
one lucky shot.
I think that's the type of vibe we're going to be on. It's going to be one of those nights. I don't think that night is tonight at all, but it's going to be one of those nights where somebody lands that one lucky shot. And you know what? Thinking about it, that one lucky shot could be potentially delivered from whoever wins the men's Royal Rumble match. Because King is at this point in his career where it doesn't matter who wins that match. It doesn't matter who of the 30 men actually come out on top,
because he is going to defeat them all. He's gonna make them all out down.
And I think just another side note of what it is that could potentially play a factor in all of this, all of it to the biggest part of a T, is Christian. Christian, who has now been by the side of King and now has taken into a degree of kind of doing some bidding for the Universal Heavyweight Champion. And I think that's going to be ultimately one of those things that plays the biggest factor in this entire match with King and Steve. Did Christian do enough damage that's going to hinder Steve from being able to reach his full potential? But with 30 seconds left on the clock, I got to throw it to you one more time for our Universal Heavyweight Championship match. Who leaves as the winner?
King.
That's a unanimous decision, because I also believe that it's going to be King. But if we're going to talk about King retaining, then that means we got one more big thing to talk about. And you know what that is? That is the men's Royal Rumble matchup. Somebody out of 30 men is going to punch his ticket to Revelations, the main event of Revelations, to compete for the Universal Heavyweight Championship. Of the 30 men, Sierra, who do you think is the most likely?
I think I'm gonna give this one up to a personal favorite of mine. I'm gonna have to give it up to Ramos.
Rude Boy Ramos. He's one of those. He's for sure one of those standout competitors, because how do you bet against Ramos?
Or Tyler. Sure, if he's in this, I'm pretty sure he is in here, but yep, Tyler.
Yeah, Tyler is another one. And it's funny, like, these different names are being thrown out here, because There is the Tylers. There is the Travis Amirs. There is the Blazes. It's so many different names. Like, I could be here for a long time naming off these people that have actual credentials that would make them a credible threat to everybody. But truth be told, if you got to think about it from a creating a star moment, is one person that went the distance in a gauntlet match and he hasn't done anything since then, and that man is Iron Man Oxley. He just beat Donnie. He just beat Donnie, and now this is a match designed for somebody like him.
That's a good one.
You gotta think truthfully and honestly. This is a match. It creates stars. And Iron Man Oxley could truthfully be going straight to the main event. And the bad part, we got a man in this match who, if he wins, it'll be more than a moment of creating a star. It'll give him the biggest advantage that we've ever seen. And that man I'm talking about is Coden X.
That's a nice one too.
Coden X is the current holder of the Warzone guarantee. He's guaranteed a championship matchup at any given point that he may want it with King. And truth be told, I do not know what it is that will actually happen if Coden X wins the Royal Rumble. And he's got his guaranteed match at Revelations. Like, if he loses, and then he attacks King after. Like, it's too many different ways that this matchup can go, and it's so many different people that have so much history with King. Imagine a Revelations main event of Tyler versus King. The matchup we've never seen, or the one man that was able to prevent all of this getting his chance to right the biggest wrong of history, Travis Amir. What if Travis Amir can win the Royal Rumble and then correct his own fate? It's too many options for the men's Royal Rumble, and it's going to be a hell of a matchup with whoever it is that wins tonight and King. But all of this right here, this has been our very first kickoff show, I can say. And with all of that, that brings us to a close. This has been, of course, the people you normally hear on this channel. This has been Apex the New King and Miss Sierra J. If you like whatever it is that you hear or have heard and are going to stay tuned to the actual Road to Glory pay-per-view, don't forget to like, subscribe, like this video, because it took a while to put it together, you feel me? And we're going to see everybody here for the actual launch of Road to Glory.
Bye.